Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Camberley, UK, and in this short video I will talk about how to issue and deploy the SL-UserMode keys. So, first of all, what is an SL-UserMode key and how many types of software keys do we have? There are three kinds of SL keys. Legacy. It is a type that we cannot generate anymore with the modern LDK 7.6. They were generated by previous version of LDK prior to version 6.0. Then we have the SL-AdminMode. They offer a high degree of security and functionality, and they require the installation of the runtime environment to handle them. If you want to know more about these kind of software keys, you can have a look to the video about them published on this channel. And then we have the SL user mode keys. They do not require the runtime environment installed and they are stored directly in the file system of the machine. They are the main subject of this video. Now, let's see better what is an SL user mode key. You can think to an SL-UserMode key like a hardware dongle. The SL-UserMode keys have mostly the same features and capabilities of a hardware dongle. They have read-only and read-writable memory area. They can store features. They come with their unique serial number. They are marked with your batch code. And they have a sort of virtual clock as well to avoid time tampering. They have something more than the hardware dongles as well. They are bound to the machine through the fingerprint. This is a very important difference. While it is nearly impossible to copy an HL key due to their hardware nature, it is relatively easy to make a copy of the file where the SL user mode key is stored. This, anyway, does not mean that this attack is going to work. Thanks to the fingerprint, we are able to recognize that the machine with a cloned license is not the original one. How we do that and what is the fingerprint? We use different strategies for physical and virtual machines and different protection schemes. At the deploy time, we collect some information from the machine, such as the CPU ID, disk ID, motherboard ID. All these attributes are used to form the fingerprint. I'm going to talk more in depth about these protection strategies in a future video. So, what are the main differences between a user mode and an admin mode license? In this slide, you can see a summary of the differences. While the user mode is stored in the file system, the admin mode one is stored on the disk, but in a special area called secure storage. The user mode does not require the runtime environment installed, while the admin mode always requires this component. The user mode license does not support concurrency and it does not support the protection scheme for virtual machine called VM Type 2. This is based on the generation ID of the virtual machine. The SL user mode key, as we said, resides in the file system area of the disk and the protected application talks we did through the integrated or external license manager. Integrated means that the library of the license manager is linked to the executable, or the external one is available on Windows only platform and is a executable file that contains the license manager. The SL user mode key is locked to the machine through the fingerprint. So, what does it happen when a protected application runs and seeks for a valid license? The Sentinel LDK library distributed with the protected application or linked with it calculates the fingerprint of the machine and compares it with the one that is stored in the license. If the freshly calculated fingerprint does not match the one stored in the license is invalidated and the protected program will not run. In a future video, I will talk more in depth about this mechanism, how the fingerprint evaluation happens, and the different protection policy that you can choose when you issue a license. Let's talk now about the license activation process. As we said, we need to gather the fingerprint of the destination machine before to issue the license. This gathering phase is called activation. In only one case, we do not need to gather the fingerprint of the machine before to issue the license. This case is when we want to issue a trial license, that is even called unlocked license. I will talk about trial unlocked licenses in another video. There are three main activation methods available. The automatic one. This method uses the LDK licensing API and the EMS web services. It requires internet access and is totally transparent to the end user. The manual one. This requires internet access to the EMS customer portal and requires minimal input from the user. And the last one is the offline method. The activation happens exchanging C2V and V2C files between the end user and the ISV. It does not require a direct internet access, and we will focus on this one in this video. Some prerequisites before to start with the offline activation through the portal. The end user needs to have the product key handy. He or she will need it to log in to the EMS customer portal. You may argue why we call it offline, but the end user needs to log in to the EMS customer portal. This may sound a bit like a contradiction. It is called offline because it is not mandatory for the end user to log in to the customer portal from the same machine where he or she wants to install the license. Let's have a look now, before to proceed to the live demonstration, how the offline activation works in brief. First of all, the ISV creates an entitlement using Sentinel EMS. The entitlement creation triggers the creation of the product key, that is an alphanumeric string that is sent to the end user. The end user uses the product key to log in to the customer portal. The end user clicks on the offline activation button, and at this point, the end user can download the RAS utility that we'll use to generate the file containing the fingerprint information, that is the C2V file. The RAS utility will be used from the end user to interpret the V2C file, vendor to customer file, generated by EMS. The end user needs to run RAS utility on the computer where he or she wants to install the license. The RAS utility will generate the C2V file containing the fingerprint information that need to be sent to EMS through the customer portal. EMS interprets the C2V file and replies with a V2C file, vendor to customer file. The end user applies the V2C file on the device where the license needs to be installed using the RAS utility. RAS will interpret the V2C file and install the license on the device. And now it's the time to have a look to this process in the real world. I will start this demonstration directly from the entitlement tab of the Sentinel EMS. The first step to issue a license is to define an entitlement to consume. To create a new one, we select our batch code and then we click on the New Entitlement button. We can optionally fill the customer and the email fields. In this way, when I produce the product key is going to be shipped directly via email to the end user. I skip this in this video. I go here to the entitlement type and I set the product key. Here I can define the number of product keys that I want to generate and how many activations are consumed per product key. I leave everything to 1 for the sake of this demonstration. Now I press Add Product and I select the product that I want to license. My product is called UserMSZ. And I press Add Product to the entitlement. I can press now the Produce button and the product key is now generated. I press download and then I can open it, and this is my product key that I need to ship to the end user. I'm switching now to the end user machine. I am now on the end user machine, and for the sake of this demonstration, I have on the desktop a protected application that needs the license that we are going to deploy on this machine. So if I open it now, as you can see, we receive the error "no matching feature found." That is totally normal because the license is not there yet. Let's proceed now to log in to the customer portal. I open my browser and I browse to the customer portal. I enter now the product key that I obtained from my ISV. And I press login. I could enter some information that are retained on Sentinel EMS, but for this demonstration I will press register later to skip. I now need to click the button offline activation. The first thing that I need to do is to download, if I don't have it yet, the RAS utility, clicking on this link. I can now run this utility. I do not have any key on this machine, so I need to click installation of new protection key. And I press the button collect information. I need to decide where I want to save my C2V file, and I save it on the desktop, and I call fingerprint. Now I return to my browser and I upload the just obtained C2V file. And I press now generate. The license has been successfully generated, and so EMS produces a V2C file, vendor to customer. I click here on this link to download it. Now I apply this file through RAS utility. I move to apply license file tab, I click here, I locate the file that actually is in the downloads, I click open, and I press apply update. So the license has been deployed successfully. I can now close this utility. And I even can close my browser. Let's see now if the protected application works. So I return to the protected folder and I launch the protected application. Now the protected application works. This brings us to the end of this demonstration and this video as well. I hope you enjoyed it. Please stay tuned on our channel for further videos. Thank you and bye.